The international military aviation world was stunned when the Sukhoi Design Bureau, together with the United Aircraft Corporation, UAC, officially unveiled a mock-up of the Su-75 Checkmate fighter jet at the Max Air Show 2021 at the exhibition. Russia seemed to send a clear message that it was not giving up on the fifth-generation fighter jet race. Designed as a single-engine stealth aircraft, the Su-75 was positioned as Russia's answer to the dominance of the United States' F-35 Lightning II, which had dominated the global market. With its futuristic design, modular concept, and claimed price tag significantly lower than Western competitors, the Checkmate was immediately dubbed a dark horse in the global air power map. Russia promoted it not only as a combat platform but also as a strategic solution for countries seeking to leap directly to the fifth generation without relying on Washington. However, over time, these ambitious ambitions have come face to face with the harsh realities of global geopolitics and economics. Initially, Russia set a very aggressive schedule. The Su-75's maiden flight was planned for 2023, a deadline intended to demonstrate that the Russian aerospace industry was still capable of moving quickly despite Western pressure. However, the outbreak of the Ukrainian conflict and the subsequent large-scale international sanctions changed almost all of those initial calculations. Western sanctions severely impacted Russia's high-tech component supply chain, from avionics and microelectronics to advanced composite materials. Many systems that previously relied on imports or international collaboration now had to be replaced with domestic production, which required time, money, and retesting. As a result, the Su-75's development schedule underwent significant adjustments. In various international forums, including the Dubai Air Show, Russian officials sought to maintain market confidence by stating that the Su-75 prototype would take to the air in early 2026. They emphasized that the aircraft was currently undergoing a series of ground tests, structural tests, and combat system simulations in the laboratory. This delay clearly illustrates that international sanctions not only impact the Russian economy in general, but also directly slow down its strategic military projects. On paper, the Su-75 Checkmate remains a highly promising project. It is designed as a lighter, simpler, and significantly cheaper platform than the Su-57. While still embodying the fifth-generation fighter philosophy. The single-engine concept was chosen to reduce production and maintenance costs, while also making it more attractive to the export market. In terms of performance, the Su-75 is projected to use the MPO Saturn AL-51F1 turbofan engine, a new generation engine also being developed for advanced Su-57 variants. With this engine, the Checkmate is claimed to be capable of reaching speeds of up to Mach 1.8, have an operational range of approximately 2,900 kilometers, and supercruise capability in certain configurations. In terms of armament, the Su-75 is designed with 11 weapon mounting points, consisting of 5 internal bays to maintain stealth and 6 external bays for missions that prioritize lethality. Its total weapons payload capacity reaches 7,400 kilograms, enabling the aircraft to carry a combination of long-range air-to-air missiles, precision air-to-surface weapons, and anti-ship missiles. In keeping with modern warfare trends, Russia is also promoting the concept of developing an unmanned variant of the Su-75. This variant is designed to function as an unmanned wingman, accompanying manned aircraft on high-risk missions such as penetrating enemy air defenses, conducting reconnaissance, or conducting initial strikes. Unlike the Su-57, which focused more on domestic demand, the Su-75 was designed from the outset as an export product. Its target market is clear, global, South countries in need of air force modernization but constrained by the high cost of Western fighter jets or political restrictions imposed by the United States and its allies. For developing countries, the Su-75 offers an attractive combination of stealth technology, operational flexibility, and a claimed more affordable price. India, despite its volatile relationship with Russia, remains a potential strategic partner. Furthermore, the Middle East, Southeast Asia, Africa, and Latin America are also seen as promising markets. Ironically, sanctions against Russia have created opportunities for potential buyers. With a limited number of customers, Russia has the potential to offer more favorable pricing schemes, technology transfer, and industrial cooperation. If the conflict in Ukraine subsides and international sanctions begin to ease, the Su-75 has the potential to become one of the fastest-growing fighter jet programs in non-Western markets. Despite the ongoing promotion, the global defense analyst community still views the Su-75 with caution. Many consider the 2026 maiden flight target to be optimistic, given the significant gap between a successfully flown prototype and an aircraft truly ready for mass production and combat operation. The biggest concerns lie with funding and program sustainability. Without an early purchase commitment from a major foreign partner, the Su-75 risks suffering the same fate as several previous ambitious projects: impressive displays at exhibitions but struggling to reach full production. The development experience of the Su-57 itself serves as a reminder that the transition from concept to combat readiness takes a long time. However, if Russia can prove that the Su-75 can actually fly and demonstrate claimed performance by 2026, it would be a strong signal that the Russian aerospace industry remains relevant amidst global pressure. However, the actual presence of the Su-75 in combat units will likely take several years after its maiden flight. The Su-75 Checkmate is more than just a new fighter project, but a symbol of the resilience and ambition of Russia's military industry amidst global isolation. It represents a major gamble technologically, economically, and geopolitically. Whether the Su-75 will truly checkmate Western dominance, or remain merely a grandiose promise, depends largely on Russia's ability to navigate technological, funding, and international sanctions barriers in the coming years. In the modern defense world, timing, market confidence, and geopolitical stability are often as crucial as technological sophistication itself. The Su-75 Checkmate now stands at a historical crossroads between grand ambitions and unavoidable reality.